Sai, have you ever called customer care and ended up being completely frustrated?
Yes, Sharath, all the time. First of all, when I call the customer care, getting to a real person is an impossible task because I have to answer a whole bunch of questions, need to press a lot of keys before even I get to a real person. Even when I'm talking to a real person, the agent wouldn't understand why I called, my history or any of those details. So overall, it was a real poor experience.
Yeah, I've had the same poor experience. Wouldn't it be really cool if we can use generative AI to help the agent and make it a much better experience for the end customer?
Generative AI, that'll be really cool. How can we use generative AI in such situations?
So we can use LLMs or large language models to do a number of different things, such as summarization. So let's say we take a previous transcript, call transcript, between an agent and a customer. We run that through a large language model, and the large language model can then generate a short summary of that entire long call transcript.
Okay, so the agent will be able to understand why the customer called in the previous instances without actually looking at the whole transcript, but instead looking at just a summarized transcript that is provided by the LLMs.
That's right. We can do a couple of other things with those previous transcripts. One is sentiment analysis. And the third thing is intent classification.
Okay, so the agent already knows in advance what kind of experience the customer had in the previous instances, whether it was negative or positive experience. That is good information to have before the agent picks up the call and talks to the customer. But can you explain a little more about how intent classification can be utilized here?
Sure. So we can look at this previous call transcript, and then we can classify it as what is the main reason or intent a customer has called. So this could be things like maybe the customer is calling to ask about a particular product or a billing issue, or let's say there's a recent promotion and wanted more information about that. So the large language model is able to look at that transcript and determine what was the main intent for that conversation.
Oh, that'll be really great, because even before the agent talks to the customer, picks up the call and talks to the customer, the agent already knows a lot about the customer, knows the summary of previous conversations, why the customer called in the previous instances, and also the kind of experience the customer had. So that'll be good information to have when the agent is talking to the customer so that he can tread carefully when talking to that specific customer. That'll be helpful.
That's right. But haven't you had a lot of times when an agent is just switched over or you'll have to transfer to another agent? So that's where we can use another thing known as RAG or Retrieval Augmented Generation.
That is interesting, because every time I call the agent, I get transferred to a different agent and I have to end up saying all the things over and over again. But how does this RAG work? As in, can the agent just type in a question and get the responses back from the generative AI LLMs?
Sure. So instead of transferring to a number of different agents, RAG can help any agent become an expert on any particular topic. So that way you don't have to get transferred to another agent. So instead of typing out the question, imagine if AI could automatically be listening into the conversation. So we could have the speech to text, listening into the conversation, that text then sent to the large language model, which can then bring up the relevant information and present it to the agent so that the agent is knowledgeable about any topic that a particular customer is asking about.
Okay, that actually makes a lot of sense, because the agent doesn't need a lot of training on all the things that are available, and requires a lot of lesser switching to different agents, and the agent will be able to help the customer on the call on real time. That is good information for the agent to have. But how does the RAG framework work? Can we talk about that, and how can it be applied in such scenarios?
Sure. So let's say there are a number of different data sources. This could be things like product documentation. You could have FAQ information, as well as previous trouble tickets. All of this is text information, which can then be split up or chunked and sent to an embedding model. This embedding model can then convert all of this text into embeddings or vectors. It's really, it is just numerical information, which can then be stored into a vector database. So now when a user is asking a question, this vector database is able to understand the semantic information and then bring up the most relevant content, send that over to a large language model, which can then generate an answer and send that back over to the user.
That actually will help the agent in a lot of scenarios, because as we've been talking about, the agent doesn't know anything and everything. So having the generative AI LLMs bringing up learned information real time as the agent is talking to the customer will be really valuable.
That's right. So we can also do a number of other things. So let's say, you know, in some cases, it might still require that a particular agent needs to send some information over to another system. So think of trouble ticketing systems, where you can have a large language model automatically pre-populate all of the different fields in this trouble ticket form when it makes it easy for the agent to then just review that information.
Yes, that'll be really helpful, because usually the agents spend a lot of time in taking notes, creating those trouble tickets after the call is ended. So it'll really help boost the agent's productivity and efficiency. And all the agent needs to do is just look at the automated trouble ticket that is created and just review it and update it if needed and submit the trouble ticket. That saves a lot of time.
Exactly. Yeah. And then we can also do a couple of other things. So we can do things like product recommendation, where a large language model can automatically recommend a product based on the particular customer. So this can be also personalized. We can also do things like next best action, where we can tell the agent what is the next best thing that the agent needs to be doing while on the call. So this can really guide the entire conversation between the agent and the customer.
Well, there you have it. So with all of these things, summarization, sentiment analysis, intent classification, RAG, and these kind of generation tasks, the agent will now be able to talk to the customer and help the customer in a more productive fashion.
Right. So next time you call a customer care, hopefully you won't be as frustrated.
That will be really helpful. Thank you. If you like this video and want to see more like it, please like and subscribe. If you have any questions or want to share your thoughts about this topic, please leave a comment below.